Thank you. Joseph Campbell was a professor, writer, and public speaker who, like every other American at the time, had to confront the realities of the greatest economic disaster this country has ever faced, the Great Depression. And it was during that time that he was credited with saying, "Fear, uncertainty, and discomfort are your compasses towards growth. We must let go of the life that we have planned so as to accept the life that is waiting for us." As I sat here almost a month ago now, rifling through tribute after tribute from families about their seniors and heartbroken posts about and from said seniors, it is now that this quote truly resonates with me. Nobody could have expected nor have predicted the devastation that we have all experienced during this pandemic. This quote from Joseph Campbell fits the class of 2020 perfectly, as we must continually pursue our goals despite the unknown, never stopping until we get the job done. Take a step back in time to elementary school when we were asked, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" We were reaching for the skies even then, as eager replies of firefighter or doctor or chef filled the air like the kaleidoscope of butterflies that we are taught to nurture in science class. Take a step forward now to middle school. Our minds changed about as rapidly as our schedules did, but we never gave up looking towards the future. Finally, take one more step. We made it to high school, despite our uncertainties about what was ahead. Were we going to keep the same friends? What are we really going to do when we grow up? Is college in the cards for us? I can only speak for myself when I say this, but my path through Big Spring was crowded with what-ifs. What if I don't pass this course? What if this internship doesn't work out? What if I don't get accepted to the school of my choice? But as we sit here in the midst of these uncertain times, it is now that I have begun to realize how all of these what-ifs can shape us as individuals and simultaneously craft our futures in the process. We all had some sort of plan in place for this year, whether we realized this or not. Whether it was preparing for college, the workforce, enlisting in the military, we all had something that we were waiting for. The crushing realization that our year has not turned out the way that we have envisioned it has taken its toll on us more than we'd like to admit. But change is inevitable. It can be uncomfortable, but it is essential for growth. Take that step that you were afraid of taking, as the first is always the most daunting. Accept the uncertainties and the fears. Be bold, be fearless, and be who you truly want to be, and don't apologize for that. Thank you to our parents, whether it's for helping us with a project that we forgot was due the next morning, or for running our instruments, lunches, or gym clothes to school because we forgot them in our rush. Thank you to Mr. August for your sense of leadership and for always putting the student body at Big Spring above all. Thank you to our advisors and guidance counselors who were there to keep us on track, as well as to just give us a shoulder to lean on. Lastly, thank you to the teachers who were always there to help us when we got confused or for just being a friend, but especially for the countless hours spent preparing us for our journeys. Regardless of where we have come from, our teachers have prepared us for where we are going. To the class of 2020, I'm eternally grateful for all the moments made with you all. This is a commencement. A commencement is not an ending, but rather a beginning. It is the start of something new. And as Joseph Campbell has stated before, fear, uncertainty, and discomfort are your compasses towards growth. We must let go of the life that we have planned so as to accept the life that is waiting for us. Let the journey begin.
Don't count the days, make the days count. We spend so much time waiting for the future and counting down the days. Days until our first day of high school. Days until the first varsity game of the sport we love. Days until prom. Days until summer. Days until graduation. Most people spend so much time waiting for the future that they forget to live in the present. However, this is where the class of 2020 stands out among most. We have come to understand the importance of taking life one day at a time. To say our 4 years of high school have been unpredictable would be an understatement. The past 2 years in particular have pushed and challenged us in more ways than we ever could have imagined. Nobody would have guessed when we walked in those doors back in August, we would walk out of them for the last time in March instead of May. Our senior year was cut far too short, but that couldn't stop us from finishing the year strong. Despite the hardships, being a Bulldog has brought us so many beautiful memories that will stay with us for the rest of our lives. Our years at Big Spring have taught us lifelong lessons to help us both in the classroom and in life. If nothing else, being a Bulldog has taught us to be better people, to live in the moment, to never take a single day for granted, that adversity is a part of life, that the power of friendship and community is nothing short of incredible, to take each and every day as it comes, to face life head on and take it one day at a time. Now, we sit here together on this day, the day we have worked so hard to get to, and we can think back on all the days that helped shape us into the people we are now. Back to the days of kindergarten, where our only worry was who we would play with at recess. Back to the days of elementary school, where we spent mastering our multiplication tables. Back to the days of middle school that, let's be honest, we all wish we could forget. Back to the days of freshman year, where we tried to figure out how this high school thing worked. One day at a time, we each wrote our very own story. No matter where the days to come take us, we will always share a small part of our greater story with each other. The days we spent at Big Spring would never be the same without the incredible teachers and staff that we are so lucky to have. You have been there for us every single day. During these times of great unknown, you have worked so hard to make this new situation as normal as you could. The days our school was hit by tragedy, you were there for every single one of us. You were there on the happy days, the sad days, the stress days, and the angry days. We are able to stand here today because of each of you. Thank you for showing up for us each and every day. From freshman year until now, thank you for your part in our journey. This day and each one leading up to it would have never been possible without our families. You have guided us, encouraged us, and believed in us. Even on our worst days, you loved us and showed us what we were capable of. You took days off work to go on field trips, attend field days, see our concerts, and take care of us when we are sick. We owe so much of this to you and your unconditional love and support. From the day we entered your lives until now, thank you for your constant support of our journey. Our days as Big Spring students may have come to an end, but we will always be Bulldogs. Our time spent here has prepared us for whatever our future holds. We not only learned the Pythagorean theorem, the parts of a cell, how to write a thesis statement, and what the branches of the government are, but we learned how to work on a team, how to function when times get tough, and how to be a positive member of our community. Many days at Big Spring have prepared us for whatever we choose to do next. In the days to come, we are all about to embark on our very own journey and start writing a new chapter in our lives, one day at a time. As we head off to New York, Virginia, Tennessee, and everywhere in between, we will always share the memory of spending our high school days right here in Newville, Pennsylvania, as Big Spring Bulldogs. Thank you, Big Spring, for everything. As a class, we have spent countless days together. It feels like yesterday we were walking into the school as freshmen. I am beyond thankful to have spent the last 13 years with this class. This class is full of incredible artists, musicians, athletes, and students, but beyond all the labels, it is simply full of incredible people. Thank you for helping to fill the days with laughter, smiles, and memories. I cannot wait to see what this class accomplishes. We are prepared, we are determined, we are hardworking, and we are ever always strong. There is no doubting the success this class is going to have. I hope each of you never forget how capable you are of anything you put your mind to. Remember to help others and thank those who help you. Live each day to the fullest because you'll never get that time back. They may not know it yet, but the class of 2020 is going to change the world, one day at a time.
It is my great honor to be able to recognize the accomplishments of the class of 2020. Few classes have faced as much adversity and still achieved so much. At this time, I would like to recognize groups of students who have particularly excelled during their time at Big Spring High School. Big Spring High School is home to a number of nationally affiliated honor societies, reflecting the entire range of the academic disciplines offered in our school. Honor societies serve the purpose of setting a standard for excellence and designating those students for whom academics are a priority. Membership in these organizations is highly sought after by our seniors, and they take great pride in the wearing of the cords of their specific organizations, as it is a symbol of their hard work and commitment to excellence. I would like to congratulate all of our Honor Society members today and say that we are very proud of you. The next group of students to be recognized have demonstrated academic perfection. These scholars have secured a 4.0 grade point average or higher during their career at Big Spring High School, often taking our most challenging courses in order to do so. Our 32 students are designated by their gold stoles. Congratulations, honors seniors. 17 members of the class of 2020 have earned a distinguished diploma from the Big Spring High School. In order to qualify for this distinction, these students have maintained a 3.5 grade point average or better, have taken at least 5 honors, advanced placement, or dual enrollment level courses, completed an internship or capstone project, and have completed 150 of citizenship hours in the school, community, or career-related activities. Working towards this achievement is a 4-year commitment that emphasizes going above and beyond in both the classroom and the community. Our distinguished diploma recipients are Julia Angeny, Claire Kohick, Grace Cronister, Reagan Donato, Kaylee Ank, Dalton Eberts, Rebecca Franklin, Shelby Hoffeditz, Alexandra Kudelakis, Mary Mettler, Emma Monismith, Isabella Pittman, Gabrielle Reifsnyder, Kaylee Shado, Olivia Wibley, Ian Ward, and Carly White. Congratulations, distinguished diploma graduates. Among the most important purposes of an education is to prepare students for the next steps they will take in their lives and to give them the skills necessary to compete in and contribute to our society. Among our entire student body, there's no doubt that our seniors who attend the Cumberland Perry Area Vocational Technical School are well positioned to enter the workforce or post-secondary education with marketable skills. To our Cumberland Perry seniors, I say well done. We are proud of you and all that you have accomplished. The Big Spring class of 2020 has demonstrated that our students can not only compete, but impress at the state and national level of competition. Our FFA seniors, Emily Lindsay, member of the National Horse Evaluation Career Development Event Bronze Team, Alexis Fernball, PA State Winning Horse Evaluation Career Development Event Team, Claire Kohick, PA State Proficiency Winner Area of Goat Production, representing the state at the national level in the fall. Congratulations to all of our state and national award winners. We are proud to report that out of our 201 graduates, 125 are preparing to enter 2 or 4-year colleges, 6 will be entering career technical programs, 4 will be joining the armed forces, and 61 will be entering directly into the workforce. I am pleased to announce that collectively the class of 2020 has earned $1.2 million of scholarship money to pursue their further education over the course of the next 4 years. On behalf of your parents and guardians, I say thank you and congratulations. At this time, I would like to call attention to a small but important group of the class of 2020. I would like to acknowledge our 6 seniors designated with red, white, and blue cords who've already enlisted in the United States military. We salute and appreciate your patriotism and commitment to serve our nation. The most competitive, challenging, and prestigious senior designation is valedictorian and salutatorian, which represents the students with the two highest grade point averages in our class. Our valedictorian is Carly White, and our salutatorian is Reagan Donato. Carly is the daughter of Jason and Cindy White. Her cumulative grade point average is 4.4, and she will be attending James Madison University in the fall to study psychology. Reagan is the daughter of Scott and Nicole Donato. Reagan's cumulative grade point average is 4.39, and she will be attending Belmont University to major in music business. Congratulations on an outstanding achievement. To the class of 2020, I say congratulations. Collectively, you will forever hold the record for the most impressive senior skip day in school history. Well played. Joking aside, as I reflect on you both as a group and as individuals, I'm struck by the uniqueness of your experience. It is as if the class of 2020 was singled out from the beginning to share their personal milestones with major historical events. Born in a year that changed our country and world forever, you graduate in a year that promises to do the same and more. If any class has been marked by destiny, it is certainly yours. And with destiny's mark comes great expectations, expectations that you are more than able to fulfill. During your time at Big Spring, you've learned many things, much of which we meant to teach you and others that we most certainly did not. There are three things I hope you've learned this year that weren't on any syllabus, PowerPoint, Kahoot, or test. The first is to treat every person you meet, every opportunity that presents itself, and every interaction you have as if the date is always going to be March 12, 2020. We all learned that even the mundane things become precious when they are taken away without warning. I think if we would have known that it was going to be the last day we'd all be together, we would have drank it all in. We would have smiled more, been kinder and more patient with each other, and taken time to savor our friends and opportunities. In short, knowing that March 12th was the last day, we likely would have tried to have been the best possible versions of ourselves. The beauty is, now we know. Now we know that each day is a gift and every second is precious, and that every person in our lives is irreplaceable. We now know that tomorrow, as we think it is going to be, isn't a promise. It's more likely a mere possibility. The problem with knowledge is that it can be a burden that is constantly reminding us and challenging us to act differently, to be better. We hope you leave Big Spring not only burdened by this knowledge, but ready to act upon it by treating every day like it's March 12th. The second thing I hope you learn that we didn't set out to teach you has to do with expectations. Your ending wasn't what you expected, but there is insight to be had from this as well. This insight is beautifully captured in a quote from author and Holocaust survivor Viktor Frankl. He said, "The point is not what we expect from life, but rather what life expects from us." We hope you have learned that something powerful happens when you stop asking what you can take and instead start asking what you can give. Learning this lesson, having this mindset, allows you to look for opportunities in disappointment and to turn frustration into action. Embrace this concept. Allow it to make you a giver. Allow it to make you a person who, when asked what life expects, you can answer, "My best in service to others." How you handle disappointment and frustration will be a large factor in how satisfied you are at any given point in your life's journey. Approaching it as described is the best way to ensure a happy and fulfilled life. The final thing I hope you've learned is something we definitely tried to teach you. It's something pretty simple, a fact that we hope is self-evident, and it is this. We are so very proud of you. Your family, your teachers, and everyone at Big Spring loves you so very much and always will. We will miss you, and we can't wait to hear about the amazing things you are destined to achieve. You leave us having embodied our motto like few others. You leave us ever, always strong. At this time, I would like to introduce Dr. Richard W. Fry, superintendent of the Big Spring School District.
Graduates, some quick reflections for you this evening. I always like to reference your classmates that are set to begin a variety of next steps. Some will be setting off for colleges in places like Nashville, Tennessee at Belmont University, Fayetteville, Arkansas at the University of Arkansas, Wichita, Kansas at Wichita State University, Fairfax, Virginia, George Mason University, and many more classmates heading to State College in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, along with numerous other Pennsylvania schools. Classmates that will be heading to every corner of our world, serving our armed forces, and classmates that will be entering the workforce here in Central PA. As you take those next steps, remember the experiences that brought you to this evening and grow from those experiences. You've been through some very challenging times as a class this year, and I believe it has brought you closer than any graduating class that has preceded you. Learn and grow from those experiences and reach out to those around you. You came into this world on the heels of an event that shaped our world for a lifetime in 9/11. You are now set to finish out your public schooling experience with an equally world-challenging event, which is our current pandemic. To say this class has lived through it all is certainly an understatement. In between that life-altering start and this health and economic challenging finish to your schooling, you grew tremendously close as a class. Remember that feeling of coming together during challenging times, supporting one another, learning from one another, listening with an open mind to one another, and persevering through those incredibly challenging times together. Earlier, Nicole reflected that in the midst of uncertain times and multiple what-ifs, you need to take that step you're afraid of taking and work through the uncertainty and fears. Be bold. Carly encouraged you not to count the days, but instead make the days count. Remember those thoughts from your classmates as you spread your wings beyond Big Spring. And I, as your superintendent, want to pass along a few thoughts from me as well. Number one, never lose the energy for learning that you had as a kindergartner. Always be curious and ask questions that allow you to continue to grow. Secondly, be courageous. Research issues and thoughts that are important to you. You're heading into a world that is getting tougher to disagree on issues while maintaining civility and decorum. So do your homework and listen to diverse opinions. Remember, it's not about who yells the loudest during thought-provoking conversations, but much more about continuing to be curious and asking questions. And lastly, continue to grow and be a lifelong learner. That learning process allows you to make a difference in the world. Have a purpose and pursue it with passion. So to class of 2020, be courageous, be curious, and ask questions that can serve to guide your future, but also listen intently to those around you, not via text or social media, but by engaging and growing together. I'm confident that you're ready for the next step in your journey. So as you take that next step in life, appreciate what grew within you at Big Spring and dream about the potential that lies ahead of you. It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. William Swanson, President of the Big Spring School Board of School Directors. Mr. Swanson.
On behalf of the Big Spring School Board, I congratulate the class of 2020 and wish you all well. To say that you have faced an unusual senior year is an understatement. You were deprived of many end-of-the-year experiences, but I am going to focus on some positive things that have taken place. Here are a few. One, you made history, whether you wanted to or not. The class of 2020 will long be remembered. Number two, the senior parade of 2020 was outstanding, and senior signs were everywhere in our district. Third, your individualized commencement ceremony was a great event. Fourth, you as students were shown how much your family, teachers, and administrators care about you. Fifth, your community's support should give you great comfort. The phrase, ever always strong, has never been more appropriate. Good luck.
Megan Renee Adams. Distinguished Diploma recipient Gracie Renee Fronson. Distinguished Diploma recipient, Julia Ann Angini.
Big smile.
Elizabeth Elaine Grove. Clayton Charles Adams. Joseph Edward Allenbacher. Dakota Ryan Baird. Colton David Beck.
Thanks. I done my best.
I'll raise everybody in the middle.
Mackenzie Kioka Baker.
Thank you.
Glenn Austin Mowers. Madison Renee Farn.
Congratulations, man. Yeah. You're going to come right through the middle. Get a good picture of it. Yeah, there you go.
Distinguished Diploma recipient, Carly Elizabeth White. Wade Timothy Barrett.
Congratulations, Wade.
Thank you.
Right in the middle, bud. Just face me.
Addison Parker Lay.
Congratulations, Addison.
There you go.
Right in your middle part. Great job, bud.
Thank you.
I'm going to head down to Mr. Pettibone.
Jonathan Edward Boblett.
Yeah, Johnny!
Ready, bitch.
Alexander Jacob Patrick Walmer.
Congratulations.
Great job.
Thank you.
Porter Allen Beitler. Dalton Michael Mullins. Connor Ian Grant. Diane Lindsay Booker.
Yeah, I think we're good. Thank you.
Janelle May Pierce.
Then you're down to Mr. Penner.
Garrett Lee Russell. Hunter William Filger. Savannah Flynn Million.
Good to have you.
You didn't bring the horse today, huh?
You're gonna turn it face. Just the rest.
Your captain courage is fabulous.
Dominic Erickson Burroughs.
straight in the middle. We're going straight up. Hold you the point.
Distinguished Diploma recipient, Ian David Ward. Victoria Rose Kutzmanich. Michaela Lynn Carr. Distinguished Diploma recipient, Dalton Paul Evers. Bethany Sue Clark.
We love you, Bethany. Very proud of you. Excellent job. Dry it up, mother.
Shane Allen Balliet.
Sarah Jane Krause.
Thank you.
That is awesome.
Thanks. Am I good?
You are. You're just going to head to Mr. Weissmeyer.
Gabrielle Michelle Weissmeyer. Adam Andrew Di Gregorio.
Right in the middle, buddy. It's all about you,
buddy.
I like the Haven cap there, buddy. Got two graduates up there. So.
You guys can come closer if you want.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just... 6 feet, man.
Thank you.
Justin Tyler Ruth.
You guys can come up to the chain if you'd like.
Wyatt James Deshawn. Wyatt Remington Hoffman. Mackenzie Ann Dingman. Distinguished Diploma Recipient, Regan Maya Donato. Oren DeArmond.
Parents, you can come up closer if you'd like.
Congratulations, parents. You're going to get right in the butt. Okay.
Turn.
Great job. You're going to go down to Mr. Turner's.
Shania Lynn Hershey. Leah Marie Eichelberger. Liam Edward Ocker. Jacob William Joseph Gardner. Spencer Lewis Father. Jaslyn Aaliyah Schroeder. Alexis Jean Fernball. Mackenzie Doe Lores. Yeah. Andrew Browns. Distinguished Diploma Recipient, Rebecca Lynn Franklin. Distinguished Diploma Recipient, Alexandra Ann Koudalakis. Grace Maria Pope. James William Frederick. Dakota Mark Kottmeyer. Sydney Brooke Hutchinson. Yeah. Haley Paige Gilligan. Samantha Joyce Sprint. Jarrett James Goodman. Tyler James Cook.
You guys can come as close as you want.
Rachel Joy Ducko.
Christy Tranquility Sarnicki.
Mickey Lee Hamilton. Kimberly Marie Smith.
Morris McKinley Hess.
Hannah May Varner. Faith Leanne Peck. Casey Elizabeth Sugar.
Oh yes, you got a touch it too. It's in the middle of it.
Mark. Haley Elizabeth Kelly. Erin Elizabeth Zimmerman. Caitlin Renee Killian. Gemma Winter Rose Lowry.
Congratulations, Katie.
Rachel Ann Marcus. Andrew Scott Morrow.
Distinguished Diploma Recipient, Mary Catherine Mettler.
Distinguished Diploma Recipient, Isabella June Pittman. Wyatt Lee Miller.
Folks, you can come up as close as you want when your graduate comes up.
Shane William Ortmeyer. Joshua Christopher Miller. Zachary Michael Rogers. Bailey Marie Morrison. Alexandra Grace Schaefer. Michael
Piper.
Congratulations,
Gavin Susano Pritchard.
Colby Andrew Richmond. David William Brown. Holden Robert Schilling. Sydney Victoria Smith.
You guys can come forward if you'd like.
Zachary Shetto. Christian Anthony Sherman. Kylie Paige Sherman. Matthew Chack Schaffer. Brian Michael Wright. Brandon Daniel Shearer. Hunter James Skazipta. Mackenzie Yvonne Frick. Ava Cody Mallard. Kaylee Ann Chateau. Emily Jo Harper. Got it.
Nicole Ann Slayson. Eric Thomas Thorson. Max Kyle Williamson.
Down the ramp. Down to Mr. Penner.
Anna Elizabeth Wilson. Seth Edward Heller. Tiffany Lynn Webster. Henry. Daniel James Knox. Emily Diane Lindsay. Elizabeth Chevron.
Aurora
Lisa Sarr.
We'll get one here in the middle. Right here. No, it's all good. No problem. Right there, you can come right up. Now you get to stay there. Absolutely.
Awesome job.
Yeah, I love that. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Down into the
Karen Marie Hansen. Jordan Riley Wolf. Jeremiah Scott Leon.
Congratulations.
Alicia Lynn Canada. Cody Daniel Clark. Malachi Patrick Cleary. Distinguished Diploma recipient Claire Marie Cohen. Aiden Cole Conklin. Hannah Lorraine Young. Mackenzie Robin Ann Press.
Congratulations. Yep, straight out to Mr. Pepper.
Christopher Levi Taylor.
Congratulations, buddy. You're going to go right to the middle.
Memphis Dean Elliott. Owen Michael Finkenbinder. Haley Marie Huchenberger.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Turn right there.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Nathan James Fetchkin. Anthony Lamar Gaudioso. Deshaun Quentin Gerald. Brennan Robert Hamblin. Brandon Lee Peckendorn. Cameron James Peckendorn. Distinguished Diploma recipient, Shelby Joanne Hoffowitz. Ethan Liam Hunt. Silas William Kaiser. Sheldon Cordell Cook. Natalia Yana Leon.
Congratulations.
Jenna Paige Massaro. Christopher Duncan Malone.
Thank you.
Chloe Elise Milligan.
We're going to get right to the middle. Mr. Smith's going to get one here with us. Hold that to the floor, Mom. Towards Mr. Peck.
Thank you. Javon Michael Marie Snore. Logan Nicholas Patrick. Michelle Bardell.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Patrice and Lee Roberts. Lionel Rodriguez Antonetti.
Congratulations, Ben. We're going to stop right here in front of Mr. Owens and get a couple more pictures.
Congratulations. There you go. That boy.
Emily Jane Warrior. Joshua Logan Russell.
Congratulations, bud. Thank you. Can we go right to the middle?
Brandon Edward Shaw.
Congratulations, guys. You're going to get right to the middle, bud. Hold that diploma off and get some points.
Alan Michael Sauer. Dylan Lee Fitt. Zachary Douglas Stone. Marshall Lee Serenity.
Congratulations, bud. Now go down to Mr. Pennant. Down the ramp.
Dwight Robert Glover.
That way?
Yeah, right out where Mr. Pennant's waiting for you.
Congratulations, Dwight. Stop right in the middle, bud.
Andrew's you working on your graduation day.
Madison Grace Wirt.
Nice.
great job. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Alexis Lynn Whitten.
Colton Allen Zinn. Dalton Lee Zinn. James Clayton Wolf. William Jack Byers.
Seniors, by the power vested in me by the Big Spring Board of School Directors, I formally declare you graduates of the class of 2020. Congratulations.